Hey, what's up, guys? First of all, I just want to thank you to all the new subscribers.
You love me. You really love me.
Thank you so much for your support and taking the time to watch my episodes. I hope that it's helpful and you're able to do what you need to do and to create animations, short film, whatever you need to do. And I hope that it's helpful and more than happy to hear your thoughts. If you'd like to see something specifically, I would love to hear your thoughts. All right, well, today's episode, we're gonna talk about runway references. And I think it's a really powerful tool when it comes to creating your own original character for your animation or your short live action short film. I think that, you know, creating scenes and different angles is really important to create your animation shorts or whatever. So I want to show you how to utilize Runway Reference tool to create your scenes and so that you can create your short film. All right, guys, welcome to the Sketch Lab. All right, guys, so here's Runway. Right here in this field where it says describe your shot, you can add an image reference. So if there's a particular shot, an angle that you want, or you can use yourself as a reference. If you want a specific pose, you can take a picture of yourself. I've done that many times and worked out really well. And then you can actually apply that to your character and use that as a reference. But I'll show you how you can do that. So here we're gonna go ahead and in this section, it says references. You can go ahead and upload your image. Let's go ahead and do that. All right, so I have uploaded an image of a character I generated a little bit ago. We call him Pulsar Man. I don't know.
Wait, what?
So maybe you can find a better name. Hit me up in the comments if you have a different name. I'm pretty sure you can come up with a better one. So here is the character. He's coming out of the these doors. So the art is inspired by some of those DC animations. So this is kind of like the one I wanted to work with. So in this area, it says you can add references by using at. So which means that you can change the tag. You can tag your images, so you can change the name. So by default, it says image underscore Y. So I'm going to change this to Pulsar Man. I know this sucks. I'm sorry. Pulsar Man. We come up with a different name later. So I want a shot of a camera, just kind of close up shot of his face. So that's what I'm going to add that prompt in here. So create a close shot. Pulsar Man. So when you hit at, you'll see your image would pop up. So you click that. So in this case, Pulsar Man. And so we're going to go ahead and generate that and see what happens. All right, here you go. That's crazy. I mean, look at the consistency. So just look at the consistency with the line art. The style is still there. I mean, coming from this, from this image to that, the costume design still stayed the same. Like I said, this is a powerful tool where you can literally make your own animated shows, short film. We have arrived, guys. You know, this is a very powerful tool. I mean, you can probably, sky's the limit with this. I mean, it's just really up to your imagination. You know, plan out your scenes and just figure it out. Now, what I would do is, like, I don't care for the the line on his face like that. So I would go into Photoshop and kind of edit that out. So that's just another step that would make a huge difference, is do some editing afterwards. I mean, some of them you may not need to edit some of these images, but in some you do. So just take it as a Photoshop, do some retouching, and go from there. All right, so let's do it like a side view shot of this image. So what I'm gonna do is, the cool thing about this is now you can use this image as the reference. So down below, you'll see reference, use, vary, use in chat. Now, I'm gonna show you the chat thing later. So that's the newest feature of Runway, is you can use the chat feature. So you can just talk to it. So not vocally, maybe one day vocally, but you could just type in like one side view of this scene. And it's almost like a ChatGPT, but it's Runway's. I think it's their large language model. So here we go. So we're gonna hit reference, and we're going to remove that other image, and we're just gonna call this Pulsar and Closo. Okay, so that's what I'm gonna call it. So I want to say create a side view shot of Pulsar Band. Let's generate that. All right. So I had to do a few generations and had to like kind of switch up to prompt. So I said side view of room and character in Pulsar Band close up. So they pretty much did it. I mean, it's pretty cool. So I would remove that little thing on his shoulder and that line on his face. So I think it came out pretty awesome. So you're going to hit that button called chat mode in the upper right hand corner. Go ahead and hit that. And we're going to go ahead and upload that image into here, because I want to maybe... we're just going to test it out and just see what it looks like without his helmet. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm going to upload the image now. All right. So I have uploaded my image, and I'm going to say remove his helmet. Let's go ahead and hit generate that. All right, guys, look at that. That's pretty crazy. So I removed this helmet, and it stayed consistent. I mean, mind is blown. It's pretty crazy. Love it. I love it. I love it. All right. So let's create another scene. Is the camera to be behind him? So let's see what the result would be for that. Let's see what it comes up with. All right, guys, so here's the result of the back view. I ended up using a different shot. It was the original one where you just kind of almost see his full body walking out the door. And so the close-up shot didn't work out too well. It kind of like show like this back look like the front, which is kind of funny. So then I switched it up and said, you know, my camera... yeah, the prompt that I used said change camera position. Now I have it behind him. Keep style and tone consistent. It's pretty close, but still got the back kind of look like the front. So I'm going to have it correct that for me. So I'm going to say the back of character looks like the front, which is weird. I'm just gonna use natural ink just to see what happens. Weird. Please create to design the back view of the character. Keep style consistent. All right. I'm asking a lot. I'm doing a stress test here, because guys, you know, we're in the sketch lab, so we're gonna have to test these things out it fails, but we got to do stress tests. But there's always a workaround. Yes. So here's the crazy thing. So here's what it generated. It says, I'll fix that and create a proper back view of the character, right? Still doesn't look good. Automatically, it did this on its own. That still doesn't look quite right. Let me fix the back view properly. I've never seen that before. So yeah, that's pretty cool, man. So let's see what it comes up with. Wow. Much better. Like I said, now that looks much better. This shows a proper back view of the character with distinctive armor plating on the shoulders and upper back, along with a blue power source embedded in his spine. Would you like to see this character in action or make any other adjustment to the design? Like, that's cool. It literally, like, figured it out on its own. I've never seen that before. That's pretty cool. All right, let's be just a little nitpicky, okay? So I want to see if we can remove that glow on his spine. Not crazy about that. So I said, looks, see, just use natural language. Looks better, but I don't like the, see, this is where humans and AI can collaborate. And now this is proof here where it's getting to a point where it's actually helpful. Where, yes, you should steer the car yourself, you know, give it direction to control. But now that it's getting to a point, as you can see, where it can think for itself, like, hey, that doesn't look good. Let me try again. Instead of you telling it to try again, it can actually analyze it and will do it on its own. So that's pretty awesome. So let's see the results in a little bit. All right, here we go. I removed the power source. Much better. This is exactly what I had in mind. The helmet, they could fix that a little bit. So it says much better. Now the character does a clean back design with white armor plates on the shoulders and upper back and a streamlined black undersuit with subtle white armor details. The blue power source has been removed from his spine. Would you like to see the character in action? Maybe fix the helmet a little bit. You fix the helmet. It looks incomplete. So it's important to stress test these tools because, you know, when you're developing your shows, we have to make sure that these tools are serving you properly. It's doing what you ask it to do. So it's important to test these tools. Right now it's in beta, Chamo is in beta, but it's doing a heck of a great job following through the prompt I provided. So let's see what it comes up with. All right, so as you can see, the helmet still looked a little off. And on its own, it said, let me try one more time to get the helmet right. Like, it knows that it's off. It's like becoming autonomous. Now, it does take like a minute or two for some reason. I'm pretty sure the alpha build would be much faster. Now, that looks pretty good. That looks better. Let me try a different approach to fix that helmet. That's pretty awesome. I mean, it's not bad, but it's saying like it could do a better job. So I said, let me try a different approach to fix the helmet. It's pretty insane. Let me know in the comments what you guys think about this tool. Do you think this is helpful? Do you see yourself using this? Because I think this is a great tool to use for whatever you guys are creating. And this is only the beta version. So once they create the final version of this, it's gonna be insane. I typically use ChatGPT when I do something like this. Very, very similar layout in functionality in ChatGPT when I'm creating different shots of the scene. Now, this is built-in Runway, which is like all in one thing. So, okay, that's okay. It's a little better. So what I'll do is I'll use this and I'll just go into Photoshop and just fix that area and kind of remove these little side things. I'm not sure what that is. I could just tell it to remove it, but you guys get the gist. Now, in order to just get back into the original screen, all you do is go in your upper left-hand corner and click those little arrow, and it'll go back into back to the original part of Runway Reference, and all your generations are right here. They're here now. So leave the comments and questions down below, and I'll leave the links in the description. I hope you enjoyed it. See you guys next time.